Well, a week after Europe and a week before the start of the Autumn Internationals, today we are back to Championship matters here on Sky Sports, where for the last 5 years, the Bedford Blues have made the end-of-season playoffs. But this has been a horrible start to a new campaign. Four league losses on the bounce, and that is the same as the new boys Ealing Trailfinders. So today, these two go head-to-head, looking to get up to speed in the league that always delivers action.
They're over the try line, we're back all the way himself. What an individual score! This game has just been turned on its head. And he's dusted himself off, and he's here!
Well, prior to last weekend, Bedford had lost all seven games this season, cup and warm-up matches included, but they finally found themselves a win by beating Llanelli in the British and Irish Cup last Saturday. Something to build on, perhaps, and Ealing have certainly built rapidly. 10 years ago, they were playing at level seven in the London 3 North West Division, but life in the Championship is proving quite a test at the moment. We are underway here at 3:15. Let's bring you up to speed.
Well, Bedford are suffering somewhat of a hangover. The free-flowing Blues finally reached the Championship final last season after being perennial semi-finalists since the second tier's revamp, and gave Newcastle Falcons a run for their money in the two-legged affair. And you would think they would have kicked on from the highs of last term, but with some notable leavers in the off-season, Mike Rea's men are struggling to find the precision and an accuracy to underpin their open style. Four losses from the opening four rounds, and now the new boys, Ealing Trailfinders. Well, no less. Gina Rosario, England women's scrum half. Ben Gulliver.
We are inside.
It's 9 and 10, real impact, isn't it?
Time off.
True athlete.
9 and 10, please. 9 and 10.
So at the Cornish Park, and then some time at Worcester as well, but some more subs. No. Darryl Vinandal at scrum half, and Neville Edwards, England County's man, big boots to fill. Ross, on the wing with Josh Bassett and James Stevenson.
Number 10,
started 10, all four games, 10, scored a
10, blue,
try against 10. London Welsh, the first try of Bedford's campaign this season.
10.
Darryl Vinandal. It's a little extra zip for the final 8 or so minutes.
Having a scrum for a while, it's still slow. Incredible. Inside.
Jake Sharp, who's gone off. So a reshuffle in the back line. Michael LeBourgeois will go to 10. Pritchard has gone to 15. Henry Dodge is still out there. Atkinson.
Your angle's not good. You've got your knee on the ground.
And Burke is out there as well. So Pritchard to 15, LeBourgeois in at 10.
A little bit surprised at taking Jake Sharp off. Perhaps they feel they've done enough to close this one out, but as it is, still under a bit of pressure in the moment 22. But with Vinandal on, real live wire, loves to snipe around the side, loves to raise the tempo of the game. Much better scrum that from Ealing. And they've turned it over.
There for Commons, leaves it for Storer. Ealing still on the hunt here. There is time left. Tupai, an important tackle for him. Spurling was there as well.
Right,
he's made a real impact.
Hands out.
The replacement
no
hooker.
Here comes Stay Ealing up.
Again, though. Not without fight, are they? Huge commitment from the side, promoted into the Championship this season. Henderson now. Gulliver is there to make the tackle. Hannes Nielsen. Commons. Ward. Extra is runners. In the end, it's popped under the hands of Brendan Burke. Vinandal.
Hold blue, stay.
Bourgeois. Okay, rather scuffed, and Bun Seals is underneath it. Henderson. Lovely. Chip and gather himself from Andrew Henderson.
No.
Huge amounts of rugby in this Bedford Blues half in this second half. Just not able to break through. Similar to trying a dramatic scoring a try. Or so minutes ago, Whitcroft, it's knocked on. Veenendaal does a sensible thing and bangs it downfield and sends Ealing Trailfinders back.
Yeah, he found some good space back there and executed it well, didn't he? But
Henderson again.
Advantage over.
He chipped for himself, Veenendaal can't take it. McLean can. He's looking to give the pass to Brunshills, but in the end, sensibly, kept the ball himself. That's Hocking. Collins.
Use it.
Ben Ward looking for his forwards to take the ball up down the short side.
And this is what they must do, isn't it, into this wind. And they've done it brilliantly now for 20 minutes. Relentless round the corner. Carry after carry after carry. And they deserve something out of this game, Ealing.
Nothing else for Ealing today, it proves. That they can compete at this level. It was being questioned whether they could or not, having shipped so many tries, so many points in the opening four rounds, where they've got some real confidence from their outings. The first ever outings of the British and Irish Cup, and again showing here today at Goldington Road. They're not the walkover side that people were suggesting that they were. Veenendaal now. Needs the footballing skills and the pace. Henderson comes across and just bundles the ball. Rather luckily into touch, and it will be a Bedford line-out.
Well, it's pretty relentless stuff, isn't it? From end to end, the Ealing guys look out on their feet. There's been some fantastic performances, you'd have to say, from both sides. I think Tom Wheatcroft from Ealing has been standout in terms of getting in the face and knocking guys down. Pape carrying all day long. And from Bedford's perspective, Atkinson in the centre, three or four clean breaks and been part of everything. But there can only be.
Time is off. We're checking a tackle by Blue 12. Sorry, Ross, what did you say?
The referee wanted to have another look at this.
If there is no penalty, whose start is it?
Is there a blue ball?
Back to look at the tackle from Mark Atkinson.
Dean,
yes.
Just confirm that the question was checking the tackle, by Blue 12.
I believe it was Blue 12.
Understood. Is that just before the ball
Before the kick was kicked down the line.
Before the kick was kicked down the line.
Halfway line.
Understood. We're just having a look.
Okay, thank you.
Going back to look at how the ball ended up in Darren Veenendaal's hands and the chip down the touchline. Mark Atkinson, the man in the dock. Jury out.
Four.
Bourgeois, isn't it? It's not Mark Atkinson, he's well away. Certainly not that piece of play. That's the tackle we have been searching for. By the letter of the law, Brunshills has been upended. His legs have gone above his head. He's landed on his shoulder, and that has to come into play from the television match official.
You're absolutely right, but you can see that he releases almost instantaneously the minute he feels that he's lifting his legs above his head. I don't think there's any malice in that at all. Now, I know the letter of the law says if he comes down, it's a straight red. I'd love to see the referee.
Dean, you got me there?
Yes, Ryan.
Got a report for you.
Thank you. Go ahead.
There's no foul play.
Okay, thank you. 12. Line up blue. Yep. Yeah. Okay, line up blue. Thank you. Thanks, Ryan. No foul play.
And they're saying there's no foul play. And And I know the letter of the law says that if it comes down on his head or on his shoulder, that it's a straight red card. But I think that's absolutely the right call for the good of the game, Johnny. I know you're looking at me like I'm from Mars, but I really do think that that is the case.
So,
if you send someone off for that, it's not intentional. There's no one's hurt. There's no malice. The game carries on.
Just get this conversation on. Next break of play.
Move!
Wilkes. Ealing Trailfinders breaking away now through Sam Hockett. Been very impressive since he joined the W13 club. Ward now, the head coach, fires another pass out to Wheatcroft. Commons. Saunders.
Advantage.
Again, another penalty coming to Ealing, not releasing in the tackle. Henderson. Looks, he's strong on the ball, isn't he?
Not yet.
Bear of a man. Ward. Knew the penalty was coming. Not coming. The reason I was looking at it like that, was it depends where the player lands, whether it's on his head, shoulder or back, as to the severity of the card, whether it be red or yellow. That's all.
Man of the match, for me, is pretty easy. When you look at the actual material impact this guy has made during this game, he's been the difference between these two sides. Of three tries that were scored today, three came directly from that man's boot or hand. My IPA Green King man of the match is Jake Sharp.
Yeah, that kick across for Ollie Dodge in the first half, the first try of the game.
2 minutes, Dean. Two.
Second Dodge try.
Blue, stay in the line.
Kick through for.
Get in, please, White.
The break, wasn't it, for Pritchard try.
Just hold.
Looking like he's going to control the ship really well this season for Bedford, and looks like now that they will have their first not win straight of the season and something to move on to.
Option blue. Scrum.
But they've had to battle hard for it, haven't they?
Inside 2 minutes.
Because Ealing have shown no signs of giving up. They've carried relentlessly. They've kept on battling away. And I think it would be very deserving for them if they were to get something out of this game. 1 minute, 20 seconds left.
That win against an athlete.
Crouch!
Last week ended a seven-game losing run.
Five.
Haven't won. Since the semi-finals last season in the Championship,
yes,
Bedford. And the team that have spent most of their Championship career right at the top of the table. We pleased ultimately to get the win and the bonus point as well. Feeling out. What's more though? So he's so good at sniping around. Tom Arms now. It's a really good run for the flanker. Almost up to that 22. Tupai still full of running. Scott Spurley knows his numbers out there. Barrel flicks it up, and it's Pritchard. And that is the Bedford Blues that we have come to love over the last few seasons. Fast, free-flowing rugby.
Got you there.
Can you just check the last pass in, please?
Yes.
Time is off.
Again.
Check the last pass. And just
Dean
just
Richards wants to just double-check.
Last two passes.
For me, it's a wonderful score from Pritchard and Bedford.
Sorry. Yeah, real complete, wasn't it? Everybody involved, from the nine through to the back rowers. Well executed. Probably should have given that, Don Barrell. You'd done everything right up to that point. But it was a lovely offload to keep the ball alive there. And I don't think there's anything wrong with that. And a hat-trick for Dodge. Cuts inside, looks out, should have given it. He'd done enough there. That's a nice soft hands off the floor, and the grounding was good from Dodge.
Dean.
Take that back,
yes,
Pritchard.
You may award the try.
Didn't think there was anything wrong with that. It was a classy looking try from James Pritchard. Lovely offload from Don Barrell. His second try, two for Dodge. Two for Pritchard and one for Le Bourgeois. The back three just haven't been firing this season, and Mike Ray will be much happier, though. All five tries coming from back three. three players.
Well, they've lost some key personnel, haven't they? But Pritchard, ever present, either with the boot or scoring tries today. He'll have the last say in this game, come what may.
Yeah, he swings it around. He's swung it around too much.
Dean, your time.
Thank you.
And that has put some real gloss on the score in a game that Ealing Trailfinders. So huge amounts of character and pride and some really good rugby at times. Some Ealing, but unable to bother the scoreboard in the second half of this game. Five tries for Bedford and they have finally recorded their first league win this season.
Yeah, and I think both sides will take an awful lot from this today. Ealing know that they can compete. They're fantastic today, they never gave up. Looked defensively far more organised and got over the whitewash. But for Bedford, maybe this will launch their season. Ever present in the playoffs. We saw the Bedford of old today scoring five tries and they'll be happy with that and they march on. Next week, a huge one for Ealing.
The Blues win their first championship game since the semi-finals last season. Mike Rea said to me in the week, this game could not come quick enough. And he was like, is this the launch pad Bedford needed to get back to where they have spent the last four, five seasons, the top end of the championship table? Man of the match, Jake Sharp, is ready to speak to Bill.